Grace and peace. This is Pastor Pimple. By the grace of God, here I am at the tail end of my walk. Let me share with you something in the book of 2 Corinthians in chapter 6. Listen, yesterday I talked to you about chapter 5 and chapter 4. In chapter 5, where Paul says that we are a new creation, anybody who comes into Christ becomes a new creation. All things are passed away. Today he admonishes the children, the church at Corinth. He says, we then, as co-workers together with God, beseech you also that you receive not the grace of God in vain. How do we receive the grace of God in vain? You know, today there is so much messages talking about grace, 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 and as if grace is a license to sin. And that's what Paul is talking about. When we receive the grace of God in vain, it is when we abuse the grace of God, when we misuse the grace of God, when we use that as a license to live a life that is contrary to the will of God. Paul says, when you are in Christ, you are a new creation. You know, you're a new creation. Now, listen to how Paul had to even explain himself. He says, it is said in the Old Testament, I have heard you in a time accepted, and the day of salvation have I succored you. Behold, now is the day accepted, acceptable time. Now is the time of our salvation. And then it says, not allowing any hindrance, anything to stand in the way, anything to cause the ministry of God to be impugned. Nothing. He says, nothing. He will not even allow anything by his conduct. He says, in persecution, in suffering, I'm trying to paraphrase what Paul wrote, but he says, but in all things, approving ourselves as the ministers of God in everything. Beloved, how do you and I see ourselves in the ministry that the Lord has called us onto? You have to understand that when you are born again, when you are saved, you are called to represent Christ by the way you conduct yourself, by the way we conduct ourselves. We are to be witnesses of Christ, not only by speech, but in our deeds. And Paul is saying that, but in all things, approving ourselves as the ministers of God, you know, in God, in much patience, in afflictions, in necessities, you know, in necessities. Today, necessities have caused, you know, the necessities that we are supposed to even rejoice and delight ourselves in. No, it is not so. Ministers of gospels of the God, or the word of God, have to use that as an excuse, you know, to exploit the congregation. You know, the servant, I'm the man of God, so I don't have to have any need, I don't have to have any lack, and so the church has to give, and we are raising millions and millions of dollars from the flock of God who already are struggling to pay their bills. But Paul says, in necessities, okay, in distress, in stripes, in prison, imprisonments, in tumults, in labors, in watching all nights, in watchings, you know, in fastings, wow, in labors, in stripes, you know, in all nights, by pureness, by knowledge, long suffering, beloved, kindness, the Holy Ghost, love unfeigned, not pretended love, love unfeigned, word of truth, making sure that they proclaim the word of God truly, truly. Today, the word of God has been, destroyed. The word of God has been polluted, you know, with all kinds of strange doctrines because of advantage and because of selfish gains and selfish interests. You know, I am almost home today by the grace of God, you know, and I said, unfeigned by word of truth, the power of God, the armor of righteousness on the right hand and on the left, by honor and dishonor, by evil report and good report. He was evil spoken of. What didn't they do to Paul? He was even thought of as being a deceiver, but he says as deceivers and yet true, because he knows he was preaching the word of truth. As deceived, yet true, as unknown and yet known. You know, there are some of us, you know, we want to do everything to become popular, you know, become popular. But Paul says that was not his concerns. As not known, but he says well known. Who knew him well? God. Well known of God as being his true servant and minister of the gospel. You know, and as by honor and dishonor, as deceivers, as unknown yet well known, as dying, and behold, we live, as chastened and not killed, you know, as sorrowful yet rejoicing, as poor yet making many rich. How? By introducing them to Jesus Christ. And when you come to know Christ, you are richer than the richest person in the whole world. I'm not talking about material things, because Christ in you is the hope of glory. Christ is in you is more than money. Look, money takes wings and flies. You know, I've seen people with millions of dollars, they die and leave it and don't take it anywhere. But in Christ, when we die, there is hope. There is hope. Paul says, as poor and yet making many, many rich. As poor, yet making many, many rich. As poor, yet making many, many what? Rich. As sorrowful, yet rejoicing. Always rejoicing. You know, we are considered to be the offscoring. We are considered of people without life, because we don't go to the fashions, their big, big parties where they have all those wild dances and all those things. But he says we rejoice always because of the Holy Ghost of God in our hearts. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And as having nothing, yet possessing all things. When you have Jesus Christ, you have all things. When you have Jesus Christ, you have what? All things. You have everything. You have everything. You know, Paul, after having spoken to the church of Corinth and talking to them about what they have come into, tells them that be not unequally yoked with unbelievers. Be not unequally. Be not unequally what? Yoked. Be not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. Sadly today, that is what we do. You know, we have become unequally yoked with unbelievers because of their wealth, material things. You have ministers of the gospel have leaned themselves with Hollywood, people who corrupt the life of God with all their fashions, strange fashions and strange utterances. You have ministers of the gospel have become leaned to them. Why? So that they will achieve fame. Why? So that they can acquire material wealth. What shall it profit a man if you gain the whole world, you gain the fame in the whole world and lose your own soul? But Paul tells the church of Corinth, look, be not unequally yoked with unbelievers. For what fellowship have righteousness with unrighteousness? And what fellowship or communion has light with darkness? And what concord has Christ with Belial? Or what part has he that believes with an unbeliever? We don't have any part with them. We don't. We need to surrender our all to Christ, my beloved. And Paul continues and says that, you know, therefore come out. We should come out from amongst them and be ye separate. And when we do that, then God says that then we will be his own. My beloved, that's the word of God for us. 2 Corinthians chapter 6. Please read it. Read it prayerfully. You know, I had to do it hurriedly because you know, I have to hit the 10 minutes. I want to limit it to just 10 minutes. But you take time and study that word. 2 Corinthians chapter 6. Let the Lord bless your heart with, and let us cling to Christ. Let us love him above all, okay? This is Pastor Pimpong, and I'm right here in my backyard, right here by the grace of God. Listen, God bless you. The Lord loves you, okay? 2 Corinthians chapter 6. Read the entire chapter. Okay, and also delve into chapter 7, because we will deal with that, God willing, tomorrow. Okay, listen, God bless you. God bless you. Grace and peace to you. You are so special to God. Your soul is so special to God. Don't focus on the material things of the world. Remember, the Bible says, he who loves the world, the love of God is not in him. That's what the word of God says. He who chases after the material things of this world, the love of God is not in him. So you can tell when I mount a pulpit as a pastor and I'm urging every one of you to be chasing material wealth, I don't have the love of God. You know, Philippians chapter 3 tells us, these are people, their God is their belly. God bless you. Grace and peace in Jesus' name.